Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. I'm finally returning to YouTube videos after quite a while. I meant to return sooner, I wanted to do Inktober, but I had two conventions coming up and, you know, stuff happened and YouTube kind of got pushed to the back a bit, which I'm kind of sad about. But I've had a break and I'm finally ready to come back and make more videos, and we're starting off with the sketchbook video. But before I go into that, I have two announcements. The first announcement is that my webcomic is actually available to read. The first three pages are up. I wish I could have filmed it in the webcomic vlogs, but it was too much, I think, and it was kind of like, because I was filming all the time, it's kind of taken away from me working on the comic, but, you know, it's out. It's available to read on Taptastic, and it's called We Lurk in the Woods. It updates every Monday, and the first three pages are up. There will be a link in the description, and I am very excited to share the story with you all. Second announcement is that I have a brand new sketchbook available in my store, Envy. There will be another one coming up. It's got all my Inktobers in it, but so far the books haven't arrived yet, so. But yeah, this is my new sketchbook. I don't do them printed at home anymore. It's been too much hassle to do them. However, the old ones are still available as PDF files on my store, Envy, so if you want them, you can go grab them. But yeah, this is my new sketchbook. I'm very pleased with it. I got it printed by Awesome Merchandise and they did the colours really nicely, like it's really nice and bright. So yeah, I really like how everything came out in it. So a little preview. Yes, but that's my new sketchbook and I'm very happy with it. That's just a random piece of puff. I really like that outfit there. So yeah, let's get into this sketchbook. I remember starting it quite a long time ago, leaving it and then coming back to it. So yeah, let's see what's in here. Straight away, object heads. Also, I don't know if this bright pink highlighter will show up, but it's like super vibrant. I really like it. And by the way, don't ask me where you can get the sketchbook. They don't do them anymore. Asda used to make them, they don't now, and I'm really upset because I really like these sketchbooks. They're super good. This I really like. I want to redraw it sometime, make it an actual illustration. These very first pages are very rough though. I don't know whether it was an art block or whether I just couldn't settle on a style or something. But yeah. Also, this is from later on, but it was drawn on like printer paper, so I just stuck it in on the pages I didn't like. Yes. That was inspired by like a, we went to Sandringham House and Gardens. It's like a really old house with like these beautiful gardens, and in the walls are kind of like little seats and great big trees growing, so it's very pretty. Again, I'm getting closer to the idea of like you know, the eventual outfits of like my comic. I was gonna go for a very much more girly kind of like outfit, but I went for a more practical look instead, though I do like the girly aesthetic. Yeah, these pages are really messy. I got a bit neater, but only later on. Poses, again drawn on printer paper and put on the pages I didn't like. Yeah. I really like doing outfits like that. I don't know, I just really like that. I like the solid blocks of colour and everything. Again, ideas for my story, but it's changed a lot since this idea. Gone for some different story things. I really like that. Those two I really like, actually. Outfit ideas. Again, I'm very sorry, these first pages are really messy. Yeah. That robot leg though, that came out really cool. I really like that. Again, story ideas, so it's very, very messy. I like that though. I really like drawing the winter coats and everything. Oh, and this is when I went on like a walking trip. It was really nice though. It's like waterfalls and rocks and kind of mountains, but I wouldn't exactly call them mountains. They're like very high hills. Yeah. But we went by this cake shop and it had like these really fancy cakes. So I was just like, I gotta draw them. Yeah. And story ideas. More story ideas that I probably won't use now, so I'm not bothered if people see them. But yeah. Coloured pencil test. I really like using coloured pencil though. I don't use it that often. I kind of want to use it more. But I just don't have the idea for what to draw with coloured pencil. Here begins the Undertale. Sands and Papyrus. I don't like that page. As you can see, I don't like using pencil. I'd much rather use like a felt tip to sketch and then go over it with like a black fine liner or something. I feel like I like the effect more, especially with this drawing here. Like I started with yellow, then put a bit of grey in, and then finally put the black fine liner on, and I like how it came out. Building stuff, that came out quite nice. Little fancy sands. Oh, and I think at this point I'd watched Mad Max Fury Road and I loved it. I loved the post-apocalyptic aesthetic and everything. I've probably said that word too many times now, but whatever. Whatever. Yeah, so I wanted to draw like Alex, kind of like with that aesthetic. Stop saying that word, I'm sorry. Also, you can probably hear like the spin machine outside, I'm sorry. It's a nice day. It's like one of the few days it's been nice and bright, so yeah. Also, this is when I first got my Crayola markers, when I got the really big pack and I was really excited. So yeah, I went back and coloured some of the characters and I really love that colour. I love it a lot. This is when I was finally getting like the finally getting somewhere with the outfits. Like they were finally looking how I wanted. There we go. That's the one. It's changed now, it has changed a bit, but overall I still really like that outfit. practice, I don't know if that pen will show up, but again, it's like a really vibrant pink and I like it. More Crayola. I really love how that came out. Like, I used a pink and then a turquoise to shade and it came out really nice. I actually like it a lot. Statue ideas. Again, concepts for a story. These will probably not get used now, so I don't mind. Dogs. That I really like. I just love doing those kind of outfits, like the armor and the uniforms and everything. I love these colors. I don't know whether they are Crayola or my Zig brush pens. The blue might be the Zig brush pen. The pink might be a Crayola marker. But yeah, I was just drawing like Alex as like a Splatoon character, like what you see there. She suits it. I love Splatoon. I don't have the game, but I really like the whole thing of it. That little outfit there, I really like. Notes. I think this was kind of like an art low. Yeah, there you go, there's the art blog. I started using my Crayolas, like really just going all out with them, and this one I really like. Hold on, if I put it that way, should be able to see it, yeah. But that drawing I really like, and the colours in it. Is it in frame? Yeah. Yeah, I just really love using like, I really like Crayola marker to draw, to sketch first and then going over with a darker one. I think it comes out looking interesting. But yeah, this isn't like one of my best sketchbooks, which is a shame because this is the last of its kind. And I was upset because I wanted to do like better stuff in it. But I really like this astronaut character. I don't know whether I'll do like a separate story. They exist in the same universe as like We Lurk in the Woods, but it's like it would be like a side story. They get stranded in space, but the space in that universe is really weird. Lots of anatomy practice. Here we go, the Mad Max was taken over. You'll probably recognise like these are the war boy outfits. I just love those baggy pants with all like the belts and details. Yeah, there we go. I can't remember her name, but I really like her. Oh, and that's like my own characters dressed up as like post-apocalyptic Mad Max style outfits. Came out really nice actually. I do like them. I like that too. And I like the colours. I really enjoy that colour palette. Oh, that was kind of like some scene redraws. I thought it might help me with composition, but I don't know. These aren't very good. I think I was really struggling. Yeah, when I get, I don't like using just like plain pencil to do a whole drawing. I like to add pen and everything, so these are like kind of weird to me. Character, like a spacey character. I don't know whether they met up with the astronaut in that side story. They might, but they're supposed to be like a physical being of a cosmic storm, like a cosmic thunderstorm, but I really like them, so I gotta draw them more. And then I just drew them in like a really modern outfit with the spaced out t-shirt. Oh, and this is when I tried to draw chickens. I was drawing them from memory and they looked really bad, so I got some references and then they started to look a lot better. So always use reference, it does help. You don't have to struggle trying to do it from memory because you need to build up your visual library. So yeah, there we go, chickens. An OC? Yeah. I really like them actually. I want to draw them more. But yeah, that chicken. I like that chicken. And the heron. Oh, and this got upside down. But I got some like very. Some washi tape. And I wanted to do like some cool pictures with it, like some fashion drawings. I still do actually, because I haven't done any proper ones. Herons, a peony, I love peonies. Herons. And then that's it, that is it. There's like a little comic at the back, like this bit here. And then there's like a little like random drawing that I hadn't stuck in yet, so yeah. So, onto the second part, onto the second sketchbook. This one I started in about April. It should actually say somewhere. It was April about. You can see actually see my doctor's appointment there. Because this is about the time I had that ear infection, and every time I tried to move my head to look down or to look sideways, I would get like a vertigo feeling, and it was because there was like I'd had a cold and there was all like fluid in my ears, you know, gross stuff. So yeah, I was really struggling to draw at all because it was making everything really difficult to do. So yeah, and you can hear cars outside. I actually really like this. These types of sketchbooks are from The Works, they're £1. And they seem to take like really the coloured pencils really well. Like they'll lay the colour flat, like they won't be too streaky. As you can see like there, there. And sometimes you can get this cool effect that looks like a kind of like watercolour. I really like that. I really like this page. I like the colours. I'd like to do more fully coloured stuff like that as well. Mushrooms. I actually love drawing mushrooms. I'm not too good at like plants. Like I feel I need to get better, but I'm pretty happy with these, especially that one. Yeah, mushrooms are cool. This was we went to a neighbour's house and she does all like her ceramic. She kind of like breaks them up and sticks them together and it looks really nice, so I drew some of the patterns I saw there and like some of the bowls and stuff. I actually really like doing still lifes, especially if the like the bottles or bowls are interesting, like they're brightly coloured. But like I don't think many people are interested in that, which is kind of a shame because I really enjoy doing it. Turn that around because I really like that face. That one there, I really like it. I think that's when I started getting into doing like a biro and pencil together because I feel like it really goes nicely. That was the beginning of the cat cake stickers. My first ideas for them. Yeah, and there they are, there they are. There's two of them. These sketchbooks are much easier to turn around than the others. The big ones don't fit in the camera frame. That was when the ear problem was getting really bad. Oh. I just remember it because I remember feeling so dizzy trying to draw that little house. And then these are kind of from another sketchbook that I just stuck in here because the old sketchbook I didn't like that much. So I really like, that's one of my favourite drawings, I think, one of them. And that too, I really like how unhappy that face is. And then terrariums. I really wanted to finish these. They look really nice. I like drawing that kind of thing. And the cat cakes. Yeah. So I did do them traditionally first and then colour them digitally. Again, this is probably another one of my favourite pages. I really like that budgie. That budgie came out cute. If I can turn it round. Yeah, there we go. Budgie. But yeah, I really like the colours on this page. And this side too. I think that was done with Crayola markers. Like, I know some of it was definitely done with Crayolas. That was done with the Zig brush pens, which I think I need to replace soon because a lot of them are running out. See those little faces. I'm still struggling to draw that character. His face is kind of difficult. And then this is where I wanted to draw robots. I really like drawing robots. I'm not too good at the details, but I do enjoy drawing like non-human characters more. That probably won't show up because it's really, really bright, that colour. I think it's like a highlighter. I really like drawing with highlighter. Or at least shading with it. And even though this isn't like the best, I really like this idea of like drawing with a really colourful pen and then going around with like a lighter version of it, like the teal and then the mint green. I really like that colour combination. I'm just practicing expressions, like seeing how extreme I could push them, though these are not that extreme. I like that one though. I like that one a lot. This is where I started practicing houses. Oh boy, buildings are still really difficult to draw, but I feel like I'm getting there. But I still need to use lots of reference. I can't use it, just draw something from my head. Because I haven't got like the visual library necessary. And that's the thing, like, it's not bad to use reference. Reference helps build up your visual library in your mind. These are really, really dig. Now, I really like that sketch. I think that came out really nice. And then like the armor and designs and everything. This is stuff I want to draw more of. Flowers, I love drawing flowers. I want to get better. Because sometimes I can make it look right, and then other times it just won't come out right. It's kind of like a hit or miss. Same with buildings and backgrounds. It's either a hit or a miss. You tried. Oh, that was like cityscape practice. And cats. I think there's quite a few cats in the sketchbook. I was trying to get really good at drawing them. These two I really like. Really like that red pen. I think it's like someone said, told me what the Crayola marker is, the big chunky one. It's not a highlighter like I thought. It's the original Crayola marker, I think. I'm sorry if I got it wrong again. Oh, I really like that one. That's one of my probably one of my favorite flower drawings. I like drawing the buds, and that was actually when I sat in the garden and actually sat down and drew what I saw. So it does really help to do just like a little bit of life drawing. That's an old Minecraft character. I really miss my Minecraft characters. They were fun. Also, they're kind of easy and difficult to draw at the same time because they've just got a cube for a head, but at the same time you have to get the proportions right. So I really like that one. I still love Minecraft. Oh, I think this is We Bear Bears as humans, like I tried. Oh, I might want to try and actually redraw them as humans. I think that'd be cool. I think this is like stuff I actually did on video. I think I did that one. I think, but I know I definitely did that one. That face I like. It's a little off, but I still like it. It's just like anatomy practice. Me drawing with red biro. I like drawing with red biro. I like sketching with everything that isn't a pencil. I do like pencil for like when I plan to make a more finished drawing, but otherwise it's just like, nah, I'll use biro all the time. Me trying to get that character's face right. Oh boy. He has such a hard face to draw. But I love him. He's my boy. Well, this was actually done from my head, sort of. I think I'd seen a picture that had inspired it, so I'm getting a little bitter at those backgrounds and buildings. It's environments I'm struggling with now, which is difficult because my comic needs those environment drawings. Oh, I think that's like Ruby. From Ruby. Like, I was like slightly redesigning Yang's outfits to be a bit more practical and battle ready. Hey, it's the first Spyro challenge. Is it the first Spyro challenge? Yeah, I think it is. But there we are. My first attempt. Some Lucio. I'm not sure how to pronounce his name, but he's a cutie. And it's like Widowmaker outfit redesigns, again to make her look a bit more battle ready. And then that's like a fan character for Overwatch, because I noticed everybody was making like their own fan designs, and I had an idea for a a lady called Sunbird. Don't know. Like, she's partly cyborg. But yeah. Drunk rat. I really like the Overwatch character designs. I really like how they're kind of uniform, but at the same time, they're all like quite individual. Yeah. I really like the colours in that one. Or building practice. Sometimes I'll be good at like remembering to draw more than just one thing, and other times I'll be just like, nah. I draw whatever. Gonna turn around because I like the post-it note thing. I really like that little drawing in the corner with all the flowers too. More doodles. Character designs, I really like these too. That was when I started reading that manga or anime. The characters are pretty cute. I don't know which way to turn it. But yeah, there we go. Yeah. Pretty cool characters. Pose practice. Really like how that came out. I like how loose that looks actually. Against expression practice. I actually really like some of those faces. I get that one in the corner. Yeah, that one. I really like it. I like how toothy it is. Again, the majority of these are characters for my comic. There's that random piece of lined paper in the middle of my sketchbook. Hand practice. More fan art. I like the colours on that one. It's got like a 80s neon aesthetic. Shoes and hands. Cats. More extreme expressions. Ugh. And then like the last bit of the sketchbook, I was just determined to get rid of the pages. And there we go, it's finished on the 15th of July. Yeah. And there's like a little doodle in the back. I wish I'd filled up the covers more. I might do that in my next one. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed that. And I am going to try and do more videos. It probably won't be like every week, sadly. I would like to do that. I would like to build up going back to one video a week, or even two, possibly three. I'd really like to do three videos a week, but that's probably not going to happen for a while because I have got to get like sorted and other things and life bits. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed those sketchbooks. And thank you for watching my video. I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.